Welcome back to the Masters of Materium. And today we got a really special guest. Some of you know him as Law Tank, but he's now known as Law Boat. I'm talking about Jesse Hines. Welcome to the podcast.
Hey, thanks for having me.
Yeah, you and I have been connected, I guess, since Gallivers 2 in Malta, whereas I met Grill. And shortly after, we started the Masters of Materium. And of course, since that time, you've gone on to start your own company, Seed Starter, which we can probably do a whole show on another time. But to set the stage, for those of you that are not aware, the Mirandas team was let go a few weeks ago. And Michael McCarthy quit because of that, because he cares deeply about his team. But you can never count out a great community. And the power of the Mirandas community is being shown with a new project called Boaty, which we're going to get into in this episode. And it's important to highlight that Jason Hughes is a beast, and he's starting to build a new game on his own accord. And I'm going to pass it to you, Jesse. So maybe give, you know, your two cents on what's happened and what's happening behind the scenes related to this project, and we can get into Boaty.
Yeah, sure. So yeah, I'll try to keep it short. I know it's a long story, but the general sense is, you know, the biggest reason that I fell in love with Gala Games back in the day was Mirandas. You know, that's probably a big reason why I even joined there as an employee. And then, you know, unfortunately recently, as we've all seen, they fired all the devs and Michael left. And that mattered a lot to me, right? You know, when I bought Mirandas things, I bought them for Michael. You know, Michael sold me a vision. I don't mean that like sold me a vision. I believed in him, and I met his team and the people that he brought on. And that's why I was so into Mirandas. And for me, you know, personally, myself, when they fired those people, I felt rugged. I felt like everything I bought didn't matter anymore. And, you know, from what I learned, it wasn't just me, right? A lot of different people, a lot of people I've talked to in MOM and other groups, you know, they felt like what they were highly into, you know, what they cared about was no longer a possibility. So I was talking to a few people about, you know, what can we do? And a lot of different ideas were thrown out. And, you know, I kind of threw out that idea of, well, what if we just created a meme coin? You know, they're kind of the things. And you know, a lot of people were talking about donating money. And I figure, well, you could donate money, but you could also create this coin that, you know, could really bring a community together and get behind the idea of creating a new game, you know, that game that we all believed in, not Mirandas, but the idea, you know, behind Mirandas, the idea we all fell in love with. And that was what sparked the idea for, well, what could it be called? And, you know, I've always, for some odd reason, had an obsession with Boaty McBoatface. So that was kind of like an homage to Boaty, which, like, the story wrote itself, because we created the launch day, and then we realized like a week or a couple days later that day was like the anniversary of when Boaty McBoatface got McBoatfaced. So, yeah. That's it. That's the general sense of how we got here.
So to recap, essentially, a meme coin has been created to help fund Jason Hughes' new project. That's the gist, right?
That's the intention, right? I believe in Jason, and I love what he's been planning. At the end of the day, you know, that meeting of the mind still has to happen, right? Jason needs to want to do this, and the community needs to say, well, we love what Jason's doing, and that funding would go there in that sense. You know, that's where, if you know, that's where I think it's going to go. But who knows? You know, Jason might get a better offer somewhere else. I don't, you know, I think he's in, but that is the intention at this point.
Some birdies have told me that Michael McCarthy is going to take the summer off, heal his wounds, which obviously he's heartbroken, not surprisingly. And who knows, you know, maybe he'll join this new project. Maybe he won't. But I think if this is just my opinion, no one else's, I wouldn't be surprised to see him join this new project, especially if the momentum continues the way it has been. What's your opinion, Jesse?
Yeah, I mean, I haven't really talked to Michael much. You know, I reached out just to tell him, you know, that I'm here for him and all that stuff. I know he's got his stuff to deal with and, you know, whether it's personal, legal, whatever. But think he has the ability to stay away from something he's passionate about. So I'm not going to promise he's going to come and be involved, but I could see him one day being like, wow, I love what you're doing. I want to come and advise, or I want to come and talk, or just, you know, even be a fan and even be like a player. I don't think he's going to, you know, I can't see him staying away.
And him and Jason really had that Axel and Slash, you know, magic. You know, they just really worked well together. And they loved each other. You know, they had a really good working relationship. So it is Grill. You want to ask some questions related to Bodie on any level? And we can save all the tokenomics questions maybe for Ilum.
Sure. I had one question I actually meant to ask Jesse and I forgot about. So I think this is a perfect time to ask. But is there any planned future utility for Bodie, maybe within Jason Hughes' game or in other games in the space?
Yeah. Well, so I think the key that what we really tried to do, you know, because we've all had pretty similar experiences in terms of buying things, you know, based on promises. We didn't want to make too much promises. The promise that exists in Bodie is that it's a meme coin, and that's already essentially delivered, right? But at the end of the day, the token is going to go to fund a game, and that game is not going to be created by us, you know, the community who put money into Bodie, but it's going to be created by another studio. Maybe it's the one that Jason puts together, right? And in my opinion, I think it would be crazy for whoever that is, let's say it's Jason, to not create some utility for Bodie. And right, that's out of our hands. But he has this community, and whoever's getting funded has this community of people that are going to be passionate, that are going to want to be more passionate if there's some utility. So the long answer is, there's nothing set in stone about it, but logically it would make sense that it would ultimately happen.
What's GG Collective's involvement? And we had Forged on the show and he talked about his seed starter raise. So I think a lot of people that are listening to this are familiar with Forged and GG Collective. So what is their involvement, if any, with the Hughes project and with Bodie?
Yeah. So the idea started out with me kind of going to Forged and a couple of others with it, and Forged was just all in on the idea of Bodie, you know, the idea of what we were going to do with Bodie, you know, and all that. And so at first it just became okay, we're going to create it together and we're going to figure it out. But then we realized very soon in that, you know, neither of us and nobody else really wanted to take any kind of pre-allocation. You know, we really wanted this to be like a community token where we're not making money. We're spending money, we're spending time, but we're not, you know, making money. And then we thought, well, how can we do that? And how can we like drop this to a community initiative? And, you know, I'm working with Forge. The idea is right there, right? The GG Collective. So myself, Nate, and other people created the token. But, you know, once the sale happens and then once the airdrop happens, the rest of the tokens are being and the money from the sale are being turned over to the GG Collective to then plan out that game, to then, you know, work with Jason or, like I said, whoever else is creating that game, and in my opinion, if it was up to me, it's Jason, and then fund that, and then, you know, put somebody in point who's going to make sure that the community wishes are being met, and make sure that the team is actually developing the game that the community is asking for, and we're not just like funding some random nonsense game that has nothing to do with what we want, and the GG Collective is going to essentially be the DAO that is overseeing that and making sure that there's not just one person at the end of the day who can just fire this new team. You know, so if you think about the hypothetical of, let's say GG Collective comes to me and says, you know, the people and say, we want you to be that point person, right? And let's say that I'm this power hungry, you know, egomaniac, and I decide I'm going to fire Jason Hughes and all those people, then the GG Collective can have an emergency meeting and say, no, we're firing Jesse instead. And that's kind of where they really come in.
Now, I'm sure a lot of people listening are wondering, well, what is this game? What I would say is Jason's cooking. Let him cook. There's a lot of ideas from a fishing game to a bigger MMORPG. So, Jesse, anything you want to say about Jason's ideas, or should we just let him cook?
Yeah, I say let him cook, right? And you know, I think ultimately what's going to happen is he's going to present something, because I think it's the right way to do it in terms of we have this money that we want to fund towards something, and then there's going to be a presentation, and then we're going to open it up to others to present, right? And while I'm biased towards Jason, who knows, maybe another industry veteran comes along, but Jason's going to present whatever that is, and everyone's going to be able to see it at that point. You know, right now he's ideating, right? He's thinking it through. And if you take just a very little piece of something, you can easily be against it if you don't fully understand the full picture. So I have a general sense of what he's doing, but until he really puts that big piece together, we shouldn't really judge it, you know, but it looks awesome to me.
Yeah, no, I think he's got a lot of great ideas. There's a lot of great examples of things working from Star Atlas, which I know he's been looking at, to, you know, just some of the classic MMORPGs that have worked over time. So, Grill, any other questions before maybe we can pull up the website on screen and Elam can dive into tokenomics?
No, I think you guys covered it pretty well. So let's move forward.
Just looking over some things on the tokenomics, I'll go through each main portion here. So first off, with regards to the airdrop, I know that you made various airdrop amounts over a period of time, and then some will be distributed to various Mirandus holders. My first question is, did you manage to be able to get accurate amounts or accurate NFT values for people's Galachain Mirandus assets and or Materium on Galachain at this point?
We haven't done Materium yet. The Mirandus NFT thing, I think that we have, from my understanding, and I'm, you know, I'm not the guy who does that. If I did that, I'd get it all wrong. So I'm just doing secondhand knowledge right now from my last conversation. I think that we're able to access most of it, but where it gets tricky, I think, were any of like the newer accounts where somebody, you know, could create a Gala wallet address without actually having an original Ethereum wallet where they never transacted with Ethereum. Because when somebody has a Gala chain address and they've never transacted with their, you know, Ethereum wallet, even though they link it, you can't really pin who that goes to. So that's my understanding of the people who are going to potentially get missed. You know, that does create a confusion where you have a Mirandus NFT. If you sold it secondary on Galachain to somebody who doesn't have a wallet, it might still be reading for the person who originally bridged it on. So that's where the real issues start to happen and where the imperfections are going to come into place.
With regards to the actual airdrop itself, the claiming process, or will you have to claim it, or will those tokens be automatically just sent to the wallets?
We're still working through exactly how that's going to happen. Our current plan right now is to airdrop it, but we're looking at whether we can use the platform we're using for the sale to just do a claim, because generally, I think that's probably the easiest way for everybody, including our team.
Okay. With regards to the ongoing airdrops on the monthly increments, I think I know the answer to this, but I just want to clarify, is that for all BODY tokens in circulation, or the total BODY tokens even not in circulation? And is that including ones that came from the airdrop or just from purchase tokens? So what is the ongoing airdrop taking percentage
into account? Yeah. It's 20% of the entire supply is being distributed across. It's going to look at the total in circulation, but then it's going to subtract out team wallets. Let's say that for whatever reason, you know, tokens are minted to prepare for a future sale, or the team is holding onto BODY trying to figure out what to do with it. That's not going to be a part of the calculation. So no team wallets are going to get any distributions. No non-exist, you know, anything that's not in circulation, that's not going to get any BODI distributions. And also any wallets that are block listed, which we listed specifically as Gala Games, like store wallets, Gala Game executive wallets, are not going to get distributions either.
Just a quick question. So if the airdrop is based on the tokens in your wallet, and let's say you never touch your tokens, each airdrop each month would increase then because your amount of tokens in your wallet would increase?
Essentially, potentially, you know, unless for whatever reason more tokens are minted because there's a sale, right? You know, if that's the ultimate decision that happens. But, you know, I'd have to really sit down and think about that. But yeah, generally, if you think about it, it should increase, but everyone else's is increasing too. So it probably should stay the same, actually, if you think about it, now that I'm walking back on that. Because if everybody else is holding on to their tokens, let's assume nobody sells. Every month, it's 1/12 of the 20% being distributed. If nobody ever sold, even though your tokens are increasing, so are theirs. So you're still getting an equal amount of, you know, of the new stream.
Yeah, the percentage ratio between yours and everyone else's would remain the same as long as nobody were to transfer or sell, for sure.
Yeah.
Now, with regards to the sale itself, as of the time of recording, the initial private sale has taken place and looks like there is 351,000 USDC taken in. Is that in line with what you were expecting? From my personal perspective, I'm quite impressed with that.
Yeah, you know, to be honest, I knew that when we first did this, the idea of even marketing it was something we weren't even considering at all. So I just thought it was going to be people who were attached to a former project who want to see something new. So, you know, when I kind of put that together and the interest that we had, I had an estimate of all in after private and public, I thought it was going to be about 250,000. And I thought that was a bit of a stretch. You know, I was bullish on, you know, being with aggressive on 250,000. So it's been a shock to me, a good shock, but it's been a shock.
Yeah, no, it looks good. The current public sale has sold $420.69 worth as well at the time of recording here.
Yeah.
So onwards to the next distribution. So as not 100% of the private sale or the initial sale has been fully allotted, has a decision been made as to what will happen with those tokens? And if the public sale is not fully allotted, is there a plan at the present for that?
Yeah, so with the private sale, we had a vote, and the vote came down to, it was two options, and it was like 52% for one and 48% for the other. So instead of just saying, hey, we're going to pick one, winner, we decided to split the difference. So half of the remaining are going to get burned and half are going to go into marketing. So that leaves about, you know, if I did the math right, it's a little bit over 2% of the supply is getting burned and a little bit over 2% of the supply is going to marketing. As for the public sale, the one thing I don't want to do is make any kind of promises, because one, I don't, you know, I'm not the full decision maker here, but two, I don't want anybody to buy or make decisions based on promises. I could see it being burned. I could see it being moved for future sales. I could see it being airdropped to the holders. And it might just go down to a vote of what people think.
So the next step will be with regards to the 25% of the supply that's been allocated for rewards and liquidity. How is that going to be distributed, and what percentage would potentially be for, say, staking rewards versus the other mechanisms, or has that been subdivided at this time?
Yeah, so the key with this is we created divisions, right, of amounts, and this is 25% to rewards, LP, and all that. But we are, you know, the contract is being transferred to GG Collective, and they're going to ultimately, with the community, come up with what this actually breaks down into. So right now, what you see is the extent of it.
And the next one here is the ecosystem fund with regards to partnerships, collaborations, says community events and other activities. Are there any upcoming events planned, and or when can we expect to see activities related to that allocation of the token?
Yeah, so I'm going to give you the boring answer of, you know, in general, the sense is, you know, I know that I created this and Forge created this and other people created it, but we created it to turn it over to others. So there's nothing planned right now because the people who will plan it don't have it yet. But what I can say is that, you know, there are already a bunch of people reaching out to me and to Forge about what they want to do to add on to Bodhi. You know, people who are already planning out their mini games that, you know, when I look at it, aren't very, you know, in my mind, aren't very costly to build, and mini this and mini that. So, you know, they're pursuing their path. They're creating kind of what their pitches could look like. And they're going to ultimately turn that over to GG Collective and make pitches for little things like that, which would bring, you know, additional opportunity, you know, in the very short term. But in terms of, you know, are there events planned right now? Definitely not. You know, right now, our first reaction is, wow, this is amazing. You know, and then our second reaction is, okay, let's meet with Jason. Let's meet with other people who potentially want to do the same thing. And let's get a plan in front of the community to say, these are the games we have in front of us. Which one do we want to actually, you know, go after? Which one do we see as the vision that we first saw when we saw Mirandus?
When Bodhiverse?
Bodhiverse. Oh my gosh, I don't want to waste a lot of money on a party. But who knows? Maybe one day.
Yeah. I never did go to any of the Gala verses, but sounds like I dodged a bullet, at least on that second one.
You know, it was still a good time, though. I still had a great time there, you know, despite all the other things.
You got to wear a cape. That's a win.
I think you might have been the only guy who had a good time, though. Maybe.
Yeah, that's fair.
And the last portion of the allocation with regards to the tokenomic structure here is the marketing advisors and contributors, for which 10% has been allocated. And we see the pie chart there with all the different divisions. I do have a question. Has there been any specific advisors that have wanted to come on board? And with regards to the marketing that you mentioned previously from the portion of the unsold pre-sale, will that be taking from this fund, or is that now in addition to this?
It's now in addition to it. You know, so it's actually a question that I'm happy you asked, because, you know, a few people have looked at this, you know, marketing advisor fund and then just been like, great job, Jesse, you just allocated yourself a bunch of token. So right now, none of that 10% is spoken for. None of it is going to me. None of it's going to Forge. None of it's going to, you know, anybody else who created it. But in terms of the marketing, you know, we are thinking about talking to, you know, KOLs, and we've actually been doing it in the background. But you know, it's not one of my favorite things in the world. But what we're thinking about doing is starting small, starting with somebody, you know, that we know and we trust, who is also respected in the space, and then seeing how that goes and then continuing from there. I wouldn't be surprised if this whole 10% one day is just burnt. But, you know, that will be in the hands of the GG Collective as well, ultimately.
It sounds good. I don't have any other questions with regards to the tokenomics.
Yeah, so one last question before Gorilla kind of walks people on how to acquire Bodhi. Why Base? Like, I've been in crypto for a long time, and it's one of the chains I had never used. Really impressed with the fees. I mean, it was super cheap, super fast. Yeah, curious why that decision was made.
Yeah, so one of the biggest things was to make it easy for, in terms of reading the blockchain and doing things that are related to NFTs that people hold, we wanted it to be an Ethereum L2. And I know there's a million of them, you know, and I know that there were, you know, there's at least 10 that I feel like we would have had similar experiences on. But, you know, in talking to a good amount of people in the space, who are degenerates, even more degen than I am, in the meme coin space, a lot of them just think the next place for meme coins is Base, and it's starting to be Base. You know, Solana has had a big boost in activity, and we considered Solana, but we kept, you know, hearing back from a lot of people who are well respected in the space that Base is the place to be. So we just decided to try to be forward thinking and launch on a place that, you know, has some meme coins but isn't massive into it, to try to be one of the earlier ones, because, you know, if it does gain traction like we think it will, and it would make sense that it does based on, you know, it is generally easy other than some things and the fees are low. If it does gain that traction, we're primed to be in a good position as an early meme coin on that chain.
Yeah, Base is the place. Bro, you want to pull up the site and maybe we can have Jesse kind of walk people how to do it.
Oh, yeah, just one more thing I just wanted to say, that when we started thinking about Base, we then were talking about making our like Twitter handle, you know, Bodhi on something, Bodhi on Solana, Bodhi on this, Bodhi on Base. And we just all liked Bob, you know, Bodhi on Base, and Bob fits with the boat thing, like Bob it in the water. So that was, you know, that was part of the sales pitch.
It all ties in.
Yeah.
Makes sense. You know, alliteration is always a good thing in marketing. So, anyways, Grill, whenever you're ready, let's pull it up and have Jesse guide people.
Okay, cool. So when you come to the site, you know, generally, unless you've loaded the site before, there's going to be a pop-up here. And that pop-up will basically, you know, show the results of the pre-sale. And then it'll say, you know, the pre-sale is closed, but you still have a chance for the public sale. It's still live. And on that pop-up, there's actually a button that you can click, and it will take you right to the purchase page. But other than that, you have a few options. One is at the top of the page here on the left, there's a button under the words Bodhi, and it says Bodhi sale. And that will take you to a separate page where you can purchase it. The other option, if you don't want to click that, is you can just literally scroll down. Scroll down, and then it comes right in there. It pops up. We've embedded it into the website. Okay. And, you know, this is the place where you can buy. There should be a Connect wallet a little bit above, I think. Yeah, Connect wallet ultimately. So the key is to be able to purchase Bodhi, you have to have Ethereum for gas and USDC both on Base chain. So if you don't have that, you know, that's where you have to first take the steps where you might want to look at the white paper at the how to buy that we were looking before and figure out how to actually bridge your Ethereum to Base and your USDC to Base. You know, the easiest way that for me, you know, and for some US customers is on Coinbase, because Coinbase allows you to literally withdraw, you know, even if your Ethereum is on ETH and your USDC is on ETH, you can withdraw it on Base chain. If not, you can go to, I think it's bridge.base.org. And, you know, it's not a perfect UX, but you can ultimately get your ETH and your USDC on Base. And then you just connect that wallet that has the Ethereum and the USDC. And you essentially, you know, after you've connected your wallet, if you can scroll down, well, I guess you haven't connected your wallet, it will pop up and you'll be able to enter in it the amount of money that you want to put into the token.
Here's how I did it, which was, I think, relatively easy. Not for everyone, because not everybody can use Binance, but I just sent some ETH to Binance, and then I extracted it using the Base chain. And once when I was on Base, I swapped it on Uniswap for some USDC, and that was it. I kept a little bit so I could do the transactions. And
I didn't realize that Binance allows you to do that too, because Coinbase does too. But Binance is another great option that I didn't realize they could withdraw to Base chain too.
Yeah, super fast, super cheap.
Yeah.
So there you go. And Jesse, you've been super helpful as well, helping people out. So if you have any questions, of course, hit Jesse up. We'll put the links, of course, in the description down below to the white paper and the main site. So just dive in. Of course, do your own research. Never invest more than you can afford to lose. All that good stuff. Jesse, any final thoughts before we wrap up?
Yeah, no, I think the biggest key to this that I want people to know is that, you know, this is an experience, right? It's not, you know, anything can be an investment to anyone. Right. But the intention of Bodhi isn't just to make a super get rich quick, you know, meme coin. The money that we're raising isn't just going to go back into the coin. The money's going to go into a team that we're all going to believe in. And that team might create utility for the token, which might do something. But, you know, if you're coming in and your goal is like, I want to get rich today, you know, it's probably not the best investment. You know, now meme coins go up and they go down, and that's based on people. But, you know, we're really doing this because of what we believe in. We're a group who believes in Jason Hughes and the rest of the Mirandas team. And, you know, I'm pretty certain that if anyone learns about them and what they've done and what they want to do, you'll believe in them too. That's all I have to say.
Love it. Grill, Ilum, any final thoughts, questions?
No, it's to kind of continue on that. I think it's this has really shown the power of community and the community that's been built and kind of tossed aside by Gala. Not to talk too much about Gala, but that seems like they kind of just tossed us to the side, and we've now rallied behind this, and it's pretty amazing what's happened in such a short amount of time.
Well, it's exceeded the vast majority of Gala sales over the last couple of years. So I'm sure people at Gala are probably aware of that.
I don't know. I hope that it's positive. I hope that they realize that one day, you know, if they open up the bridge, this could be on Gala chain, because that could be super cool. But we'll see.
There you go. The power of a great community that believe in, and you can just never underestimate that in crypto. To me, that's everything. At the end of the day, what makes any project survive is just people believing, rallying, continuing to hold. So yeah, we'll see what the future holds for Bodhi, but so far it's been, as Ilum said, pretty mind-blowing.
A wild ride.
There you go. And our next video that's going to be dropping shortly after this one will be our reactions to what's happened to the Mirandas team and the future of MOM. So make sure you stay tuned to that. And as always, mastersofmaterium.com. Our Discord is still up. We're still alive. MOM's not going anywhere. And yeah, join us. Thank you.